A journey of 1,000 miles must begin with a single step, Lao Tzu. My friends, your single step is to commit yourself every day, 10 to 15 minutes following these charts. What we teach you here can be used on any stock or ETF that is chartable. And we teach you how to discover if something is chartable. It's called backtracking. We talk about that all the time. If you will spend time with us, you don't have to know what you're doing at first. Go to chartingwealth.com, sign up. That means you'll get the daily reviews emailed to you. In that email will be a daily training for you. There will be PDFs for your daily market worksheet, weekly market worksheet, and trade worksheets. We share those trainings all the time on how to fill out those worksheets. Listen, follow, pay attention, and begin creating your stock trader's journal, putting it all together. Yes, you can get our book at some point. You can become a Patreon sponsor. But first, just see if you've got what it takes to do the work. 10 to 15 minutes, but you wouldn't believe how most people can't even find that amount of time. Oh, they might want to spend 5 or 6 hours once a week. Well, that's not the ticket to success in what we do. Let's jump into these charts. We see stocks and bonds and Bitcoin down, gold up. Let's talk about how we see this week starting. Check out the S&P 500 already trying to cross over, going down. We see the price percent oscillator trying to pull through the red signal line. We have a very weak, I guess you would call that a red spinning top, not quite a doji. Red down candle, little wick on the bottom, tall wick on the top. All well with inside the green candle the prior week. So again, week, starting the week off weekly. We go to the 2-day, and of course we see the first day of this latest 2-day candle crossing over, going down strongly. Again, not down all that much for the day, 0.77%. It's different when we get to the Qs here in a minute. But again, S&P rolling over. And we go, and the derivative oscillator still positive but weakening. We go to the half day, and of course we saw that half day chart rotate over back on last Wednesday in the morning, and has just been slowly sliding down strongly in the morning, not so much in the afternoon on Monday. Derivative oscillator gaining momentum, price percent oscillator spiking over. So market starting the week off decidedly weak on the S&P. The Qs, that's the NASDAQ 100 down 2.59%. That is a big downer. Look at that, pushing through the weekly trend line, crossing over strongly, pulling away. Just the first day of the latest weekly candle, so that's 5-day candle, 4 more days to go, but look how the price percent oscillator crossing over, derivative oscillator going negative. 2-day chart crossing over very strong, actually crossed over. We talked about this on Friday and accelerating, pushing through that weekly trend line. Look at that derivative oscillator just plumbing down low. Half day, we crossed over, gosh, all the way back right after things were peaking on Monday the 16th of February, and then just dramatically over the day on Monday, hammering down. So that's what we see happening in stocks. What are bonds doing? You would think they might be going up. No, they're continuing on, plumbing down 0.76%. We have that 2-day recross underway that continues to be nice. Price percent oscillator accelerating going down. Derivative oscillator heading down. 2-day chart. First day of this latest 2-day candle. Again, just moving on down quite nice. See about redrawing that trend line a little better. There we go. That's pretty nice. Uh-oh, somehow I think I grabbed hold of the weekly. Didn't mean to do that. Let me reset that. Somehow I pulled that out of the way. See if we can get that lined up a little better for us. There we go. Okay, so got that weekly reset, but that 2-day continuing to move down, derivative oscillator, price percent oscillator, half day. What do we see there? Again, just continuing to move down. Now you'll look and see that our jumping in point on that 2-day recross around the 150 mark or so, and of course has plumbed a low so far of 141.72. So that's nice. in just those few days. So that's where we are on bonds. Now gold, what's gold doing for us? Up 1.50%. Remember, we had that two-day recross back in mid-January. Is that right? Yes, all the way back in mid-January. Slid sideways for 2 weeks, then down strong 3 weeks. This week, not so strong going down. In fact, pushing up some. Derivative oscillator losing some of its downward momentum. Price percent oscillator flattening. And again, it's a solid green down candle with a wick on the bottom. That's a slowdown in the down movement. It's not an open box candle yet. Go to the two-day, that's where you see an open box starting to form. Price percent oscillator negative but going up. Derivative oscillator losing downward momentum after several days of downward momentum. Still below the two-day trend line and the weekly, so we'll watch and see how that continues to shape up. Half-day chart, we saw it cross over in the morning, head on in that direction in the afternoon, but not as high as the peak. Still below the weekly and the two-day. So could gold have hit a bottom and be booming up finally? We don't know that. That'd be nice. We'll wait for confirmation with a weekly vertical crossover. That's where we are on our four big charts. Let's take a look at Bitcoin. Well, how does Bitcoin start the week off? Down a little bit, 0.25% for the day. We see a green up candle forming. And again, we see the price percent oscillator flat. Derivative oscillator gaining a little upward momentum. Go to the two-day, and again, we can see the price trying to push up higher, but the price percent oscillator flat, derivative oscillator gaining a little upward momentum. And of course, what's up with that half-day? That's where we see it crossing over, going down in the morning, a little bit more in the afternoon. So keep your eye on things. We see what Bitcoin has done, how it's gone down for a day and recovered and sort of pulled back and then tried to push up. So we still have that two-day recross in effect, and that weekly chart has flattened and weakened, so do be careful. Pay attention. Fill out your show notes if you are, again, in that practice trade on Bitcoin. Remember, we're not a stock calling service. We're an education firm. We want you to practice trade with us. And of course, once you think you're getting good at that, you can do a little fractional trading where you might go in and get maybe $100 worth of Bitcoin. And that's percent is easy to follow there and see then what you can do with a little bit of skin in the game. You'll be able to learn how to buy and how to sell, what it's like to enter a trade, the difference between the bid and the ask. You'll pay attention to all those things and learn those valuable lessons. But that's after you've paper traded for a while and been successful at doing that. It takes some time, my friends. It is not some kind of game that you learn the magic secret overnight. This is like learning to ride a bicycle, getting a degree in college, whatever it might be. You got to put the time in. If you do that, the rewards will come. God bless, my friends. All the best from the whole team at Charting Wealth World Headquarters.